Hare Krishna. So welcome for today's Bhagavad Gita discussion. So today we will start from verse number 21. So in the last discussion, in the last section, we have seen the blowing of the conch shells by different parties and different warriors. So after the blowing of the conch shells, Arjuna desires to see both the armies who have come for fighting. So he orders Lord Krishna to take the chariot in between both the armies. So that is the verse for today's discussion. We will start with verse number 21. Arjuna uvacha sena yor ubhayor madhye ratam sthapayam echyuta yavadetan nirikshaham chuddukaman avasthitan kermaya sahayodhavyam asminrana samudyame. So this is the verse. We will see the meaning. Sena yor ubhayor madhye ratam sthapayam echyuta means here Arjuna is ordering Lord Krishna, addressing him as Achyuta, to take his chariot in between both the armies. Then he says he wants to see who has come, who are those warriors who have come to fight with him on the battlefield, and with today with whom he needs to fight. That is what is explained in the remaining two lines. So the most important thing here is Krishna is addressed as Achyuta. Achyuta means infallible, because Krishna never fails to reciprocate with his pure devotees. Here Lord Krishna has become charioteer for his friend and devotee Arjuna, and Krishna takes a special pleasure in following the orders of the pure devotees. He takes more pleasure in following the orders of his pure devotees rather than he ordering devotees. So this is the Bhaktavatsalata of Lord Krishna. So he took such a menial position as a chariot driver for his pure devotee Arjuna. So not only that, Arjuna in this verse wanted to see the opposite party or all the warriors specifically, to see who all have come here to fight on behalf of Duryodhana, to please this evil minded Duryodhana. And also he also want to estimate the strength of the opposite party with whom he has to fight. So that he explains in the next verse, which Arjuna states. So we will just see the next verse, recite and see the translation. That is verse number 23. Yotsyamanan avekshaham yaete trasamagata dartha rashtrasya durbuddher yudde priyachikirshavah. Let me see those who have come here to fight, wishing to please the evil minded son of Dhritarashtra. So now we will see the next verse, verse number 24.
Sanjaya uvacha eva mukto rishikesho gudakeshena bharata senayor ubhayor madhye sthapayitvam ratottamam.
So here Sanjaya is saying
eva mukto rishikesho gudakeshena bharata.
So following the order of Arjuna, here Arjuna is addressed as Gudakesha and Krishna is addressed as Rishikesha. So here following the order of Gudakesha, Rishikesha does as follows. What he does? Sena yor ubhayor madhye. He takes the chariot in between both the armies and places it at the midst of the armies. Sthapayitvam radottamam. So here Arjuna is addressed as Gudakesha. Gudakesha meaning is one who conquered over sleep. Sleep also means ignorance. That means Arjuna has conquered over both sleep and ignorance. He could do it, this one specifically, because he could always remember Lord Krishna, because of which he could conquer over ignorance and sleep. So one who thinks constantly of Krishna can conquer over sleep and ignorance, and this is called as Krishna consciousness. And here Krishna is addressed as Rishikesha again, because he is the controller of senses and mind of every living entity. And here, knowing well the mind of Arjuna, why he is telling him to place the chariot, he did so and spoke the following words in the next verse. So we will see the next verse now, verse number 25.
Bhishma Drona Pramukatah Sarvesham cha mahikshitam uvacha partha pashyaitan samavetan kuruniti.
So here Krishna is telling this to Arjuna. Uvacha partha pashyaitan. Arjuna, just see, after placing the chariot in front of mainly Bhishma and Drona and also many other warriors who are all belonging to the Kuru dynasty. So he is telling, who all have assembled here, samavetan kurun iti. This is the meaning of this verse. Very well knowing the mind of Arjuna, Krishna spoke these words. And after this, Arjuna sees, observes the armies on the battlefield of Kurukshetra. And what happens after Arjuna's observation of the armies, that we will see in the next video. Till then, thank you very much for watching. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.